pay range quartile that I have up here. These are based on what our current pay ranges are. And you can see through here, this would be our, what the scales are. These are the specific jobs that are here, the job titles. And then within each job title, you can see who's within each quartile. So when I talk about quartiles, the first quartile means there's no to little experience, like 3 to 0 years. And this second quartile, it is 4 to 9 years. Third quartile is 10 to 14 years. And fourth quartile is 15 plus years. So as you are getting more and more experience within your role, you're going to move more slowly towards that higher range of the scale. But this is where everyone is currently at within that their scale. And then these are just the proposed pay structures that I had for 2022. I have the current one that's on black, what the pay structure is. I did a proposed pay structure below midpoint, and then I did a proposed pay scale at midpoint. Midpoint is where market is typically paying. Any questions?
Before we move on, just real quick, for Mr. Carino's benefit, let me introduce staff. So Christine Ward is our human resource manager right up front. Dennis Sloan to your right is our lieutenant ranger. Right behind Christine is Matt McHugh, our director of planning and operations. And all the way back is Sandy Ward, our marketing manager. So a few people with staff with us this morning. So, any questions, any discussion on compensations?
I would just say that when you compare people that are at the low end of the pay scale, the percentages get exaggerated as you give increases. It's still in real dollar terms, you know, a few dollars here, a few dollars there. It's not an exorbitant amount, but because they're making really too low a wage, it appears to be a higher percentage, but it's just because we're coming off a low number. So it's not, you know, you can't get entry level employees and hold on to them unless you're competitive.
So we did present you with two options, a low mid or an at mid. One of the things that we're requesting today is a motion to approve one of the two.
I have one question.
Yeah, sure.
Does this bring pay structure up to industry standards? Is that what you're...
Yeah, I took a look at all those different industries, and this will bring us up to where we will be competitive within the market.
And using the example, so if we were to do at mid, one of our lower paid grades are some of our entry level workers at grade 2, and employees would start at about $17 an hour. So, and we presented you with a below mid where they would start at $15
So those would be for new hires only, or those would be for the police staff?
This would be for everyone on staff, yeah. Grades 1 through 10.
How does this correlate with the American raise we gave back in December?
The adjustments would be on top of the wages you gave back in December. So. Any other questions, any other discussion?
You got to really look at this other. This report shows the hourly wages, you know, that they're making hourly. This is for example. This is an average.
This is exactly the same.
Yeah.
Do we really have employees paying $8.46 an hour?
No.
No.
Thank God, no.
No.
But that is the old starting rate from 2015. If you like, one of the things that's planned for executive session.
You good, Howard? We possibly, what Howard's talking about is, if you go down to the bottom line of below and at midpoint, you basically have the exact same numbers. Min, mid, max. And yet on this report, it shows the difference is about $100,000 between the two.
You're looking at grade 10, correct?
Yeah, this report shows $100,000 difference between the two options. This report is showing the same numbers at the bottom. Is that accurate, or?
Can you explain that?
So when you say the numbers at the bottom, are you talking about grade 10?
No, I'm just talking about all grades. Or grade 10, is it? Oh, by grade, I see what you're saying. So grade 10's not getting a measurable increase.
Right, as you can see when you look
it's
at that.
It's all at the bottom end of the pay scale.
Yeah, our first two pay grades and the bottom two pay grades are the ones that are most affected with wage scales.
Yeah, so there's about $100,000 difference, and it's mostly at the lower end of the pay scale.
Right.
Correct. That's correct.
And this is actual, and this is pay range.
That's correct. We would like a motion to approve one of the two, or we can go into executive session if you would like to discuss how compensations and adjustments may affect individuals.
I would be a bit more.
Okay.
It's my vote. I'll second that.
Okay. All right. Very good. A motion, we have a second. Any other questions or discussion? If not, we can call the vote. Mr. Preston?
Yes.
Mr. Nocenzi?
Yes.
Mr. Bates?
Yes.
And Mr. Gurino?
Yes.
Gurino. it's like my Hungarian name. I'll try not to butcher it.
John, would you mind just saying what that vote was for? I couldn't hear you.
Sure. It was a, yep. There were two proposals given.
We're updating that from 2015 to 2022, 7 years, we have not changed the pay ranges. We need to update them in order to retain the employees that we have, as well as attract talent.
So the motion was to
midpoint is you're either going to be below midpoint, which means that you're going to pay people less than what we believe the middle of the market is, or you're going to pay them at the middle. So we voted for at the middle.
Okay. Thank you. That answer your question, Mark?
I think so.
Yeah, there were two options that you saw in the board packet that we provided, and then the board voted for the at the middle.
Okay. Thank you.
All right. Moving on to hunting rules and regulations, and a memo provided by Lieutenant Dennis Sloan. As many of you know, we host a hunting program for whitetail deer management, both in archery and firearms. And rather than read Lieutenant Sloan's entire memo, this was an agenda item that Pat asked to put on the agenda. So we will go ahead and open it up for questions. There's no vote associated with it unless a motion comes forward. But just want to have a discussion on our hunting rules and regulations.
My only comment is it needs to be prominent or front page on the website when that activity is taken. It can't be buried in where the person has to scroll for hunting. It only happens how many times a year? Once, twice?
It depends on what we're